Decision making in axillary brachial plexus block. We're going to talk about where is the best place to place the transducer, where is the best place to place a needle for complete axillary brachial plexus block. We will talk about how many injections, the volumes, and the stock maneuvers to accomplish the best images of the musculocutaneous nerve. The stock maneuvers, by definition, at NYSORA are the maneuvers that get you the best image at about 90% of the time if you follow them. Let's see this. Okay, so we're going to do an axillary brachial plexus block for hand surgery. And here we can see the typical arm position is an abduction with the elbow flexed. This is very important because it allows you access to the axillary crease, as we can see over here. So the probe position is always in the axillary crease, never looking into the axilla, but rather looking straight, perpendicular to the humerus. So if we take that approach here, you can clearly see everything that we are interested about the axillary brachial plexus. That's the axillary brachial plexus sheath. Up here, we can see the median nerve. That's the ulnar nerve. And that's the radial nerve over here underneath the big axillary artery, releasing the pressure on the transducer. So more pressure, less pressure, more pressure, less pressure. Closes and opens the veins. It's a very important maneuver for safety to assure that we recognize all the necessary vessels in the axillary brachial plexus sheath. Now, in here, outside of the sheath, we also see the musculocutaneous nerve. Now, if we scan the musculocutaneous nerve more distally and proximally, we can see how it kind of swims into the plexus and swims away from the plexus, depending on your scanning level. That here is the conjoined tendon. So everything that we want to do with the brachial plexus block in the axilla is inject local anesthetic into this triangular space. It does require a little bit of a strategy or decision making in that, are we going to inject it above the artery or below the artery, or what is the first course of action? Here, I would think we want to pass the needle underneath the axillary artery in between the two vessels and then pass it into the sheath. This is usually accompanied by a perceptible click. Then we inject 8 milliliters of local anesthetic here for the radial nerve. Depending on the spread, we may or may not need additional injections, but if the spread is not entirely around the plexus, we're gonna go up above the artery. There we go, the needle goes in using an in-plane approach, and the needle is approaching. If we can stop right there, we can see pulsations right there or contractions. If you look at the hand is not moving, so that's a local contraction of the biceps now, which is musculocutaneous nerve. So if we didn't have that contraction of the biceps, possibly we could have gone through the nerve without noticing it. This is the value of the nerve stimulation. So now we're going to avoid the musculocutaneous nerve and we pass in underneath the axillary artery. Here, I'm expecting to get a little pop as we enter. There we go, there was that pop. You can see the whole structure twisted with the artery and its adventitia, and once we passed it, there was a little click. Okay, so at this point in time, we're going to check. There is no motor response to nerve stimulation, and nerve stimulator is always set up at 0.5 or so. Aspiration is negative, and injection pressure is normal. And now, as we start injecting, we can clearly see how the local anesthetic is distributing nicely inside the axillary brachial plexus sheath and actually displacing the radial nerve. Anytime we see that displacement, we know that our injection is spot on in the posterior part of the axillary brachial plexus sheath. So there was eight milliliters of local anesthetic, radial nerve. So now we're going to go back to the needle and we're going to redirect the needle above the axillary artery. Go back. Okay, we're still going through the biceps. We may get a local twitch. Now we want to negotiate our way between the median nerve and the artery. You want to distort the artery as you're going in. There we go. That was a perceptible, invisible pop. Aspiration negative, twitch absent, and here we go. Injection starts. We can advance the needle slightly to about 1 o'clock position. Push a bit more. Yeah, there we go. Aspiration negative, and here we go. Very nice distribution of the local anesthetic inside the axillary brachial plexus sheath. Here we're going to inject another 8 milliliter. The only thing that's left to block is actually the musculocutaneous nerve. So let's go back into biceps, sharp angle redirection. Yes, almost out of plane, if you will. And we're going to steer the needle in the fascial sheath between the biceps muscle and coracobrachialis. A little bit, pull back into that sheath, and that's what we want. So that is now nice injection for the musculocutaneous nerve, as you can see right there. Good, we can take the needle out, and let's examine what we got. So that's the brachial plexus sheath again. The local anesthetic has distributed it already, but we can clearly see local around the ulnar nerve, median nerve, and the radial nerve. There you go. The whole sheath is filled with the local anesthetic, and the musculocutaneous nerve is also surrounded by the local anesthetic in the tissue sheath that surrounds it. And that was it, the decision making in axillary brachial plexus block. If you like our video, make sure that you leave a comment or suggestion as to how you do an axillary brachial plexus block in your practice, how many injections you perform, do you block individual nerves separately, what are the volumes you like to use, or what are the best positions and tricks to get the best images for axillary brachial plexus block. Likewise, if you do like our videos, make sure you subscribe and never miss a beat. Until next time.